bells ring. Are you listening? In the lane, snow is glistening. A beautiful sight, we're happy tonight. Walking in a winter wonderland. Gone away is the bluebird, here to stay is a new bird. He sings a love song as we go along, walking in a winter wonderland. In the meadow we can build a snowman, then pretend that he is Parson Brown. He'll say, are you married? We'll say, no man, but you can do the job when you're in town. Later on, we'll conspire as we dream by the fire to face unafraid the plans that we made, walking in a winter wonderland.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. There's no response there. We can say good afternoon. Good afternoon, everyone. It is really, really so nice to see you all for our Christingle service. Can you give me a wave if you've ever been to a Christingle service before? And now, give me a wave if either you've never been to a Christingle service, or you think last time you came, you were so young, you don't really remember when you last came to a Christingle service. Then give me a bit of a wave. You don't remember, a few of us don't remember, and I actually saw a few grown-ups there who also didn't quite remember when they were last at a Christingle service. So it's really good to see you. We're going to have lots of fun today, and we're going to be thinking about why we celebrate Jesus' birthday at Christmas time. Hopefully, everybody who's a child has got their own little Christingle kit. Bless you. Hopefully, everyone's got a Christingle kit with them, have they? Fantastic. Do you want to hold those up to me? Ah, brilliant. So you've got your oranges in there and lots of bits and bobs. And then during the service, we're going to dress your oranges up as Christingles. So I'll tell you all about that when we do that. Now, obviously, this year, things are a little bit different, like the fact we've done two Christingles so we could fit everybody in today. So we've already had one at 2:30, but you guys are a much bigger crowd, so it's really nice to see you guys, as well as the group who we saw at 2:30. We're obviously a bit more spread out, and grown-ups are wearing face masks, unless if exempt, so thank you for doing that, which helps to keep us all safe. The other thing that's a bit different this year is we're not allowed to do singing. But to make up for it, we've got lots of actions that we're going to be doing and some really great songs that we're going to be listening to help us still to get into the Christmas feel. At the end of the service, when we get our cakes, it's gone very posh now. Rather than us all getting up and queuing and getting close to each other, we now stay sitting in our places, and then we'll have a team of people who will bring out your cakes to you to eat. So that will be very posh waiter and waitress service here today. We're going to start off with a time to pray. So we could put our hands together. That helps us to concentrate on talking to God. And if you want to make the prayer your prayer, as well as my prayer at the end, you just say, Amen. Dear God, we want to say thank you that we're here for our Christingle service today. We want to say thank you for all the good things that you've given us and the opportunity we have to celebrate Jesus' birthday this Christmas time. So please help us to have a time that we really enjoy today, and a time when we learn more about how special you are and how special the gift of Jesus being born at Christmas is. And as we think about all the good things you've given us, sometimes we remember that we've done some bad things that we need to say sorry to you for. And so we say, sorry, God, now, for the times when we haven't loved people how we should. Sorry for the times when we haven't cared for people the way you'd like us to. And sorry for the times when we haven't loved you how you'd like us to love you. But we thank you that when we say sorry, you say, that's okay. You forgive us and you give us a brand new start. Amen. Fantastic. Well, as I said, we can't sing songs today, but we can do actions. And we're going to do a song that's got lots and lots of actions to it now. I'm going to show them to you. Then I'm wondering if anybody feels brave enough to help me at the front. I could do with maybe two or three people. We'll all socially distance ourselves at the front so that everyone can see the actions. This is a song all about presents. We go, presents, we love presents. We turn them around and around. Wondering what is in them, we shake them up and down. Big ones, we go as big as we can, small or tiny, no matter what they are, the greatest present of them all was found beneath a star. And what do you think we're talking about with the greatest present? We're talking about baby Jesus. So we go, Jesus, he's the greatest present of all time. And we look at our watches like that. Jesus, a better gift you'll never, ever find. Glory be to God, we hear the angels call. Peace on earth to everyone, a saviour has been born. And there's a few other bits with stars and shepherds, but we'll deal with that when we come to it. Who feels confident they can do the actions? I've seen lots of children's hands up and hardly any grown-ups with that, but I'm sure grown-ups can do the actions just as well. Who feels really confident that they want to come and help me at the front? Do you guys want to help me at the front? Your hands like were nearly touching the ceiling there. That's fantastic. So how are you doing? If you stand, maybe one of you stands about here on that spot there. And if you stand, you can stand, you're in the same bubble. You can stand next to each other. That would be great. Would anyone else like to help me with the actions today? Anyone else feeling confident to do actions today? Did you want to have a go? Do you want to have a go, Albie? No pressure if you don't want to. Fantastic. We've got some volunteers. Sorry, you're hidden behind the pillar. Come on up and help me out. That would be fantastic. And you can bring other people with you from your bubble as well. That would be brilliant. So how about if you guys stand about here? Okay. Brilliant. Well done. And let's all stand up and give this song a big go. I'll stand here so you guys can copy me, but everyone else will be copying you, okay? So get ready to start off with our big presents, okay? Just like that, well done.
Jesus,
that. You were fantastic. Go and have a sit down in your places. Did you want to go back to join your family bubble over there? That was brilliant. And I could see your family bubble, by the way. I could see them watching you on the screen and pointing you out, really impressed with all your actions. So well done. I really love Christmas time. I love going around and seeing all the decorations. I really like all the Christmassy lights. I wonder, has anyone here seen any of the Christmas lights this year so far? Or maybe some of you have got some Christmas lights at home. I'll start with, yeah. Where did you see your Christmas lights? Can you think of any that you've really liked? You can. Can you tell me where they were? Can you think of any Christmas tree lights or any Christmas lights that you really liked? Oh, I really like those ones. The flashy ones when they change colour and you get all the different colours. I love those ones. I know the ones you mean. Fantastic. Can anyone else think of anywhere else we might see some Christmassy lights? Yes, Albie. Do you want a few moments to think about that one? Talk to your grown-ups and come back to me if it comes back to you. Yes. The golden ones are great, aren't they? Yeah, and you've got the nice sort of shimmer around them. Has anyone put their Christmas tree up yet? I think lots of people this year, we just decided to do our Christmas trees really early. I've got my parents here. They normally do it on Christmas Eve, and they've done their Christmas tree. That's amazing. So we've got lots of us have Christmas trees. Who's got their Christmas tree lights on their trees? Lots of us. Fantastic. So it's really nice, isn't it, going around seeing all the lights. Maybe we go into town and see some of the lights that are decorating our town as well. And Christmas, the Christmas story, when we think about Jesus being born, is also full of lots and lots of lights. I'm wondering if anyone can think of any lights they know about in the Christmas story. Maybe any things that suddenly happened with big lights, or maybe anything people saw in the sky with lights. What are you thinking of? The star. What a brilliant answer. In fact, that now you've got a snowflake on your top, haven't you? It looks like a star. When I looked properly, I realised it's a snowflake, but it looks like a star. So the star is a really good example of a bright light in the Christmas story. And I know a few of you have got some Bible readings that you're going to help us to read today. Has anyone got with them Matthew chapter 2? Has anyone been given that? Fantastic. So those of you with Matthew chapter 2, do you feel brave to come up and talk in front of the microphone? That would be brilliant. And even though they're reading from a bit of paper, it is taken from the Bible. So this is a really special part of God's word in the Bible. And we're going to hear all about that star that happened on the first ever Christmas.
The star and the wise men have seen the in the east, west went on ahead of them until it stopped over the place where the child was. They were thrilled and excited to see the star. When the men went into the house and saw the child with Mary, his mother, they knelt and worshipped him. They took their gifts of gold, frankincense and myrrh and gave them to him.
Fantastic. Thank you very much. That was so beautifully read. Go and have a sit down in your space again. So we know that when baby Jesus was born, that first Christmas, it was so special that God sent a star above where Jesus was to show the wise men where he was so that they could go and visit him. That must have been amazing, following a star and then finding Jesus. Can anyone think of any other lights in the Bible story about Jesus being born? Any other idea of any big, bright lights? I'll give you a clue. Mary saw one of these before Jesus was born. The shepherds saw lots of these, and the whole sky was filled with these, singing and praising God. What do you think? Angels. Brilliant answer. That's what I was looking for. In the story of Christmas, there are loads of angels who come with big, bright lights and saying important things from God. So I'm wondering, has anyone got Luke chapter 2, which is another part from the Bible? It's over this way. Fantastic. Come on up. And if you want to, you're fine to take, yeah, face coverings are fine off at the front. Then we just put them on again before we sit down because we've got a bit of extra space here to make it nice and safe.
That night in the field near Bethlehem, some shepherds were guarding their sheep. All at once, an angel came down to them from the Lord, and brightness of the Lord's glory flashed around them. The shepherds were frightened, but the angel said, "Don't be afraid. I have good news for you, which will make everyone happy. This very day, in King David's hometown, a Saviour was born for you. He is the Jesus Christ. You will know who he is because you will find him dressed in baby clothes and lying on a bed of hay." Suddenly, many other angels came down from heaven and joined in praising God. They said, "Praise God in heaven, peace on earth to everyone who pleases God."
Fantastic. Thank you very much. Can you imagine what that would have been like if you're a simple shepherd just looking after your sheep and suddenly an angel from God comes and tells you the best news in the world, that Jesus has been born? Wouldn't that be exciting? Especially as a normal shepherd, you might not really expect anyone like an angel to come and see you, but that's what happened to those shepherds. When we build our Christingles later, you'll see on the top of them, they've also got a light on them. And we're going to think about why the light is on the top of the Christingle in just a moment. But you know what? The Christingle has got lots and lots of bits and bobs on it that remind us about Jesus and remind us about why it's so special that we celebrate his birthday at Christmas time. And now, I'm sure grown-ups, if you've had children before, like lots of children, your grown-ups will say, it's really special when a child gets born. In fact, that happened in our family a few weeks ago. We had baby Joshua, who's just over there at the moment. He was born as a little brother to Beatrice. There's a nice little picture of him from when he was a few days old, just up here. I just like showing the picture off a little bit. I've got lots of you as well, Bea, that I've shown off as well, haven't I? So it was really, really special when a baby is born. And it really helped me to think about how special it is celebrating Jesus' birthday at Christmas time. That he came into the world as a little baby, but transformed everybody's lives. However, I have been a little bit busy, and what I wanted to do was to get a sort of slightly bigger than normal orange so that I could show you how to dress your oranges and turn them into Christingles. Because I thought if I get a small orange, people at the back won't be able to see it. So I need a sort of slightly bigger orange. Didn't have time to get one, but not to fear. Julian, where's Julian? He's been busy. I've asked him to get me an orange. I've not actually seen it yet, but...
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Thanks, Julian. What's that?
It's your Christingle.
No, it's not a Christingle. That's like a big orange outfit.
Yes.
I've asked you to get me like a slightly bigger than normal orange,
yeah,
so that I can dress it up as a Christingle.
Ah,
what
slight
have you
miscommunication. I thought that you wanted me to get something that was orange so you could dress up as a Christingle.
So I can dress up as a Christingle?
Yes.
No, I don't think anyone's come here to see me dress as a Christingle, have you? Okay, just give me a wave if you want me to dress as a Christingle. And give me a wave if you don't want me to.
The okay. People have voted, Tom.
The people have voted. I'm going to be dressing up as a Christingle as I teach everyone else how to make their Christingles.
Yes!
Okay, fine. Pop that down 2 metres away. This is going to be interesting. Well, if you've got your Christingle pack with you, can I just check everyone has got one? Because I think we've got a few spares. If anyone is without, then we've got a few spares. Everyone's got their Christingle packs. If you get the orange out of your Christingle pack, then, okay? When you look at the orange, you will see that it's a globe shape, the same shape as the world. And the globe shape reminds us, yeah, this is a bit interesting, isn't it, about the world that God made. When God made the world, everything in it, I know it's weird, everything in it was perfect. What has it got, some straps at the back to do? Let's give this a bit of a go then. Julian, the problem is this one's not really very round. This is just like my body.
Give it time.
What's it doing? This is a bit weird.
It's growing very
it's
slowly.
It's growing very slowly. It's inflating. Has this got like a pump in it?
I've tried to think of everything as well.
Wow, I'm blowing up like a Christingle. So I'm blowing up the same shape as a big world shape, reminding us about the world that God made, just like your oranges. What's that?
This is your Christingle hat.
My Christingle hat. Oh no. I'm massive, look. This is weird. Okay.
Christingle gloves.
And some Christingle gloves as well. This is very interesting. Okay. I'm not going to ask Julian to do a job again. But thank you. So, well, So I'm now dressed as the orange. This is interesting. In your packs, I'm just going to try and continue like normal. In your packs, you've hopefully got some cocktail sticks. There should be 4 cocktail sticks. Can you just count and check you've got 4 cocktail sticks in your kits? Brilliant. They're hopefully sellotaped with your stick, with your sweets if you can't find them. Fantastic. And also, I wonder how many seasons are there in the year? Can anyone think how many seasons are? So there's winter, spring, summer, how many? 4 seasons, spring, summer, winter, and autumn. And so if you've got 4 sticks and there's 4 seasons, what do you think the sticks might be reminding us of? Perfect, the seasons. So we know that God made the world and it was perfect when he made it. And he made it so good that everything worked together. So you've got one season following another season following another season. And what you need to do with your sticks is stick those in around the Christingle, one on each quarter, okay? Julian, have you got any cocktail sticks for me?
Certainly have, Tom. Obviously, couldn't get really large cocktail sticks, so I had to think on my feet here slightly. So we've got, a spear, a broom handle, a couple of nets.
Nice.
They're the same. It's so.
Have you got 5
work,
there?
Honestly.
You only need 4.
I know you only need 4. I bought a spare.
But you bought a spare this time.
I bought a spare. Let's.
Okay, so you've got your cocktail sticks. You stick those into the outside to remind us about the seasons that God made in the world. And then each season brings along fruit, doesn't it? And the stuff that we can eat. And we normally nowadays use sweets. I think in the olden days they used to use more like raisins, but now we mostly put sweets on. And so hopefully you've got some sweets that you can stick into your sticks, and they remind us about all the good food that God's given us and all the stuff that he's provided. Julian, have you got any sweets?
Certainly have. Celebrations.
Celebrations.
The only.
Okay, well, I guess that's a big version of the sweets that these guys have got.
So
pop one on there.
We didn't eat enough chocolates to have 4.
Don't worry. And so I'll just give everyone a few minutes just to put their sweets onto their sticks as well. I do always find with normal Christingles, I mean, this is just weird, with normal Christingles when I make them, I always have a bit of a problem. By the time I leave the church, all my sweets have gone. I don't know why. Does anyone else ever have that problem? The vanishing sweets. I can see Jill's just nodding her head. She knows me too well. She's like, yep, I can believe that. It's fairly true. Fantastic. Well then, what do we need next?
I think we might need a light.
We do. We need a light on the top of the on top of the Christingle. And you've all got a candle. But before we stick that in, I wonder, has anyone got the Bible reading from John? It's John chapter 8, verse 12. Who's got that one? Fantastic. Do you guys want to come up here? And I'll move back as easily as I can with this big outfit on and have a read for that one for us.
Once again, Jesus spoke to the people. This time he said, I am the light for the world. Follow me and you won't be walking in the dark. You will have the light that gives life.
Fantastic. Thank you very much. I would give you a clap if I could, but I can't. But everyone else can give you a big clap. Fantastic. And that's actually something that Jesus said when he was older. He said that when he was a man teaching people and showing people how much God loved them. And he described himself as being like a light for the whole world, showing people the best way to live. And so that's why on the top of our Christingle, we're going to jab in the candles, but just underneath the candle, you need to put a bit of aluminium foil because that will firstly catch the wax if it drips, but secondly, it will give a bit of a reflection, so it will shine the light even more. And that reminds me about how we can also reflect the light of Jesus. He shows us the best way to live, and we can show love to people as well. Julian, have you got a candle? Candle's not going to be safe for this, is it?
I thought a naked flame on top of your head would be a little against health and safety, so we've gone for...
Ah, brilliant.
The head torch.
A head torch. I'm going to have to pop these down then, aren't I? And put on a head torch. What about the aluminium foil? Have you got any?
We have an aluminium scarf.
Brilliant.
Bespokely made for your neck.
Bespokely made for me. Fantastic. Let's pop that one on. Can you pass me my seasons again?
So I can
still be reminded about God's seasons that he's made in the world. Fantastic. Nearly got your eye out there. That was close.
I've got another one.
Oh, that's good. Fantastic. Well, I wonder how you're getting on with your Christingles. Maybe you could hold them up in the air. I'd love to see what you've got so far. They look absolutely fantastic. I love these. Wow, so many brilliant Christingles. I'm looking around. I know there's a few people watching at home, and I hope you get a chance to maybe buy yourself an orange and some bits to go into it, and you can also build a Christingle, even if it's not straight away now, make a Christingle at home. Well, I'll tell you what, all of these Christingles look a lot better than the one you and I've made here, so thanks for that. Wasn't quite what we were planning. But there is one big difference. When I'm looking at my Christingle, I've not got the red ribbon, and all of yours have got that. I wonder if anyone's yet been pricked by their Christingle. Has anyone touched the outside and gone, ouch, that hurt? You have, yeah? Bad luck. It doesn't hurt too much, but you do think, whoops, pricked myself on the cocktail sticks. You know what? That reminds me about how sometimes the world isn't perfect. Sometimes things go wrong in the world. Things sometimes caused by us when we do bad things. The things we sometimes call sin. That's the posh word for it. Anything that we do that makes God sad and goes against what he'd like us to do. And those prickly bits remind me sometimes about the bad stuff in the world. But God loves the world so much that he didn't want us to have to be punished when we do things wrong, to be punished for the bad stuff that we've done. And he gave us a way out. Jesus was, when he was a grown up, he taught people for about 3 years. And then he was really brutally put onto a cross where he died before he came to life again, beating death. When he died, he bled blood. What colour do you think that was? Red. Yeah, you're going to say red as well. And what colour are your ribbons? Red. So, I think you've probably figured it out already. The red ribbons remind us that as well as Jesus coming into the world, he also died to forgive all of us, and he bled the red blood. I'm just going to adjust these, and I wonder if you can give me that red ribbon as well to make the same reminder.
We're going to go round you.
That's fine. Fantastic. Thank you, Michael, very much. But when you look at your Christingles, when you look at all the bits of it, what do you still have is the bit you probably noticed the most lighting up your Christingle. Hopefully, it's the candle on the top, the light of the world. I wonder, as you're nice and close to the front, do you mind reading that Bible verse again? Would that be all right? That Jesus being the light of the world. You did such a great job of it first time. And that's just a really special message for us to remember this Christmas time.
Once again, Jesus spoke to his people. This time he said, I am the light of the world. Follow me and you won't be walking in the dark. You will have the light that gives life.
Fantastic. Thank you very much. That was brilliant. And what a special message that is. And so I hope that this year, as you get a chance to look at your Christingles, maybe as you take them home, or as you eat the sweets, or maybe some of you already eaten the sweets. Has anyone already eaten their sweets? Oh, you've done. My sister-in-law has, oh dear. As you eat the sweets, as you look at your Christingles, as you celebrate the whole of Christmas this year, I'd really encourage you to think about what Jesus said about himself being the light of the world, and think about how many people's lives have been transformed when they've chosen to follow Jesus. And maybe this Christmas might be a time for you to think also about choosing to follow Jesus yourself as well. Well, we're going to think a little bit more about what the Christingle is now. We've got a song, and we've got some live music that we're going to listen to from Marilyn on the piano. She's going to sing us the Christingle song. And we can follow the words on the screen.
Which is round like the world God made. For he showed us his loving creation. In the world we see his power displayed. Sing, Christingle, sing, Christingle, sing, Christingle, it's the light of Christ. Sing, Christingle, sing, Christingle. For the seasons and the fruits of the earth God gives. The Christingle is here to remind us of the love of God for all that lives. Sing, Christingle, sing, Christingle, sing, Christingle, it's the light of Christ. Sing, Christingle, sing, Christingle. Remember his birth again, but the red ribbon.
We're going to spend just a few moments in prayer now, and I'm going to lead us in some prayers, and I find the Christingle is a good way to help me to decide what to pray about. Because first of all, here we've got the beautiful world that God made through Jesus, and Marilyn's going to put the fruits on it. And this reminds me of all that we need to say thank you to God for the wonderful things that he has made. So let's pray. Lord Jesus, we thank you that you are the creator of the world. We thank you for all the beautiful things that you've given us, the animals and the beautiful scenery and one another. And we pray that you help us to treat the world well that you've made, and to treat others well that you've made. And Lord, as we think about all the good things that you've given us, we all want to say a special thank you this week for the vaccine. We've been praying for a vaccine, and thank you, Lord Jesus, that there is one now, and we pray that it will be produced and spread around the world. Amen. And the other thing, Marilyn, is this red ribbon, isn't it?
That's right. We were thinking just now, weren't we, about how the red ribbon is to remind us that we sometimes do things wrong, don't we? And that Jesus came not just as creator, but also as saviour. So let's just pray. Father, we know that sometimes we do things wrong and we say things that we shouldn't say. And we thank you so much that Jesus came to die on the cross to pay for our sins, so that when we come to you and say that we're sorry, you forgive us. We thank you for that, Lord. Amen.
Amen. And the final part of the Christingle is the candle on top, which Marilyn's going to put there and light. And this reminds me that Jesus is the light of the world. So let me pray again. Lord Jesus, we pray that you would bring your light into the lives of people who specially need it right now. We pray for those who maybe have lost a loved one recently. We pray for those who are ill or whose family has someone who's ill. And we pray that you bring them your light and your peace. And Lord Jesus, thank you for the light you bring into our lives at Christmas time. Thank you for Christmas. Help us to remember that what we're really celebrating is your birth. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We will be, yeah. Well, we're coming up now to the time when it's time for us to light our Christingles. And for this, we'll have Rob and Marilyn are going to go down the aisles with a taper. So what I'm going to ask is, if possible, if an adult can be on the end, mainly just because you've got longer arms, so it's a safer distance to light them, then they'll light one Christingle, then you can pass it along your family group, and then in a moment we'll turn the lights out, we'll play a really nice Christmas song, and that will help us to reflect on what a Christingle is for and why we celebrate Christmas. And can you see over here, Julian's lighting our Advent candles. We've got, can you see, five candles in total. And we light one of the red ones each week during Advent. So this is our third week in Advent, hence you're lighting the third candle. Next week, if you're coming along to our Christmas Eve service, you'll see the fourth one gets lit. And then if you come to our Christmas Day service, or probably we'll keep it out the week after as well, then you'll see the fifth candle in the middle lit as well. And that white one is there to remind us about Jesus' birthday, Jesus being born as the light of the world, like we've been talking about today. Well, has everyone... Oh, we've still got a few candles on this side being lit. I'm going to stay away from the candles with this on, I think. Probably all for the best. Fantastic. So, I think we've got some light switch monitors all set up to go. We're going to just turn the lights down now, but you'll still be able to see by the lights from our Christingles, reminding us about Jesus as the light of the world. And we're going to play a really nice Christmas song to help us with that. Doesn't that look great? Do you take a few minutes just to look around as well, being careful of your own Christingle, of course. So now it's time for us, we'll switch our lights back on in the building. It's time for us to blow out the candles on our Christingle. But these are yours to keep now, so I suggest do take them home with you today, and maybe you can find another time to light them. Grown-ups, don't worry if you need to take your face mask off to help blow them. That's something, one of those things you can't do a face mask on, as Beatrice and I discovered this morning, didn't we, when I was trying to blow a candle out. It really wouldn't work. Ah, fantastic. So, has everyone got their candles out now? Well done. Now, at our normal tea time services, those of you who come most times will know, we always sing Happy Birthday to those who've got their birthdays in whichever month it is at the time. And this month, it is December. We can't sing Happy Birthday, but we can still offer you something even better than that anyway, a Happy Birthday prayer, where we're going to pray for you. So I wonder, who's got a birthday in December? If you have, maybe if you can stand up. Do stand up, grown-ups included. At the service earlier, only one person stood up, and I thought, there must be more than one person who's got a birthday. Is it your birthday as well? Fantastic. So, and don't worry, we're not going to like bring you up to the front or do embarrassing stuff to you, but it'd just be great to know who you are. Then we can say a big happy birthday to you. And we've got a prayer on the screen. I wonder if we can try and say it all together and read the words on the screen. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the happiness of birthdays and for bringing your children safely through another year. Throughout the year to come, may they continue to grow in the knowledge of your faithfulness and of your love for them, in Jesus Christ. Amen. And let's give all those people standing up a big happy birthday clap. And that can apply to anyone else with a birthday in December who just didn't want to stand up then, but who secretly wishing they'd had a happy birthday as well. Fantastic. Well, now it's time for our church family news. So I'm going to waddle off this way and hand over to Rob again.
Well, our church family news, that's what we call it when we just tell everyone about other good things that are happening coming up. And the first thing to mention is that on Christmas Eve at 2:30 and 4:30 again, we'll have our crib service. And booking for that, it's another bookable service. Booking for that will open this evening on Eventbrite, St. James Trowbridge at eventbrite.co.uk. So that's Christmas Eve at 4:30. sorry, half past two and half past four. Then on Christmas morning at 10:45, we'll have our Christmas family service. It lasts for 35 minutes. We plan it so it lasts for 35 minutes. So if you're timing turkeys, you can work it all out. Do join us for that, quarter to 11, 35 minutes. If you want to stay for the optional short communion at the end, that's another 15 minutes. But that's Christmas morning. When we get into January, we'll be having our tea time services again at 4:30 on a Sunday afternoon. And the first two of those are on the 10th and the 17th of January in here. And then on the 24th of January, we'll be starting again our breakfast church. That's 8:45, is that right, Tom?
Yeah, 8:45 till
9:45. 8:45 in the hall, bacon butties, and then some family-friendly worship, and you'll be away by 9:45 if you've got something else on Sunday morning. So that's breakfast church. And then finally, I guess many of you have already come across the Trowbridge Christmas Nativity Trail, yeah? If you haven't come across this yet, this is a great thing organized this year by the churches. It's a journey around the Nativity story, and you go from place to place around Trowbridge looking at the tableaus, and each one has a clue, and you collect all the clues, and at the end you can work out the answer, and I hear stories about prizes of chocolate. So if you'd like to take part in that, there are some leaflets by the door to pick up on the way out. So shall we go on to a blessing, Tom?
Yes, yeah, just before we do the blessing, just to say we've got cakes today, and if we all stay in our places, then our team will bring the cakes out to you, so that's a nice safe way of doing it. And also just to mention, our Facebook page will go up in a minute, so if you're a bit bored waiting for your cake to arrive and you've got your phone, you could have a good moment just to like our Facebook page. It's a good way to keep up to date with all the things that we're doing.
Thanks, Tom. So let me pray a prayer for everyone before we have our cakes. May the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, the perseverance of the wise men, the obedience of Joseph and Mary, and the peace of the Christ child be yours this Christmas. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be amongst you and remain with you always. Amen.
Amen.
Oh, the weather outside is perfect, but the fire's so delightful. Since we've no place to go, let it snow, let it snow, let it snow. It doesn't show signs of stopping. I brought some corn for popping.